Today I'm going to make a Ikebana vase. So the base will be small and then go out and then flare out. So the rim is going to be white, but the base is small. So I usually open my base a bit wider so that my hand is easier to go in there, and then compress the bottom, and then after that I will color in and make the base smaller. So you see that when I am throwing, I didn't even stretch it a whole lot here. I'm still keeping this section a bit thicker and keep it a bit wider because later on I'm going to just push it out, stretch it out, so the rim will be wider. But I want to take care of the bottom first. Right, so that's the Ikebana vase. What I was doing is trying to keep the bottom section here a bit thicker so it could hold the weight from the top while I'm stretching it. And also when I start to pull, I don't pull a whole lot from the top portion that I'm going to stretch it out, flare out. So that I have a little bit more clay there, so while I'm stretching it, it will be stronger to hold the shape. And that's the key, that without making it collapse, because you need to leave a bit more clay on the top. So when you stretch, you have a strong strength to hold the shape together. And the bottom here, I know this is still thick, so I have some room to go. I can trim more clay from the bottom, and the whole piece will look much nicer than it is now. Okay, so that's the Ikebana vase. I hope this helped. Okay, see you later.